What's good, everyone? Tyler here. Welcome back to another video. Today, I want to continue experimenting with GPT Engineer, which is one of those code generation projects that you give a prompt to and then it asks for clarification and it builds something. Now, of course, this isn't going to replace developers anytime soon, but I think it's maybe useful to learn dev stuff, or at least for people who don't have a lot of dev experience, to sort of get something started. And I should also mention that you can probably do this stuff with ChatGPT, but this is just a cool way to do it from the command line and sort of do everything in one fell swoop. So I saw this tweet by the creator of the application, how a lot of these apps that were formerly not possible are now being done. And I think it's worth checking out the GPT Engineer Discord as well. There's a lot of cool projects in there. So today I'm going to do two apps. They're going to be simple sort of index HTML and JavaScript files. One of them is going to be a sort of launch page countdown timer. And the second project is just going to be a really simple, a really simple interface to upload a thing. It's not going to have a backend, but it'll have a button that lets you select a file, and then maybe you can add to that to do stuff to the contents of the file. So let's get started. Okay, so I already have GPT Engineer cloned and sort of going in my computer. Check out that other video on my channel. It helps the channel a lot if you watch those, and that may help you get started. But really, what we're going to do here is clone or copy this main prompt file and make it for our own projects. So I'm gonna go into CD projects and create a new folder called, and remember our first project is like a landing page countdown thing, so I'll just call it countdown landing. And then inside here, I'm just gonna create our main prompt file, which is sort of the entry prompt required for this to work. So we'll create touch main prompt. And if we go check our directories, now we've got projects, countdown landing, main prompt. And I've put together sort of a prompt that I think describes this project, and I don't want to waste y'all's time and type all this out, but basically we're telling it that we're going to make like a multi-step app in JavaScript and HTML, and the final page is a countdown timer where it's going to, my guess is, write a function in JavaScript that counts down, and we're going to tell it that we want a button that when the user clicks start, it starts the countdown. We want it to build an input field for the name of the project and a input field for how many seconds until the project launch. And then here I just said create the CSS for the countdown and for the button, and then make it like 50% of the view page. I don't know what it's gonna end up looking like, but let's give it a shot. And remember, the cool thing about this sort of app is that it asks for clarification. So let's just go ahead and try to run this and see what happens. Okay, so now we're gonna go ahead and run it. And if you recall, it was in GPT Engineer project/countdown landing. Okay, so let's go, and it's going to ask us some clarifying questions. Let's see what it wants to know. Okay, details of the input validation, some CSS stuff. So could you please provide more information on the desired appearance and layout of the new page where the countdown will be displayed? So we're just gonna say, make it a simple page. The countdown should be centered and in a large font. Now it says no here. I don't know what no means. Maybe it's just angry at us. And then it's basically telling us that we're going to create a Flask app and use JavaScript for the front end. I don't want it to do that. I don't want this to make like a full-on Python application with a backend and stuff. I just want a static HTML and JavaScript page, right? So I want to be explicit about any sort of like frameworks or Flask or anything like that. So I'm going to say, do not use any Python or JavaScript frameworks. Make it a simple index.html and JavaScript page. Use window.location for routing through the steps. Let's see if that works. I don't know if this is necessary, and it's going to ask for clarifying questions as well. So let's just see what happens. So if you recall, to run this, we're going to do GPT Engineer and then the name of the project, which was countdown landing. A summary of areas that need clarification. Design the layout of the page. Design the countdown timer. What happens when it reaches zero? Specify the CSS, additional features. Could you please provide more details on the design? So it wants to know where to put the input fields and the timer and the start button. So I'm going to tell it center everything vertically. Put the start button under the product name input and seconds input field. make the button large and red slash orange gradient. Okay, run that. Okay, and as you can see, it's getting started. Actually, it only asks me one clarifying question, and it said no here. I'm not sure what that means, if it's angry at me, but let's go ahead and let it run and see what it makes. You can see it's creating the start countdown function. That's good. And again, this isn't something that you'd probably immediately put into production, but it's writing a lot of boilerplate code, which is really good. You know, who wants to write a countdown function when you could just have GPT do it? So that's awesome. And it's also doing a lot of the skeleton HTML and probably some of the styling too. I don't know what it's going to look like at the end, but you could always make tweaks. And I've actually seen some of these generative projects where you can do this, and then if something goes wrong, you sort of ask it to edit it. So maybe we'll get to one of those projects in a future video. Okay, so now it's done and it wants me to run a Python server, which is not ideal. I kind of just wanted to be able to click an index.html file and have it open in the browser, but let's see what happens when we run this server. Okay, it says it's serving on port 8000. I'm going to localhost and I've got a landing page for a product launch. Okay, we did that all with just a pretty simple prompt. So I'm gonna call this Tyler Super Product. And seconds until launch, let's just say, I'm gonna make it just a few seconds because I wanna see what happens when it gets to zero. So let's just do like 7 seconds and hit start. And it's going, okay, it's actually counting down. And when it got to zero, it didn't do anything. So I'm gonna do this again and run the whole thing again. And then I'm gonna do something that when it gets to zero, it does like a sort of celebratory emoji or something. So I'll be right back and I'm gonna change the prompt and rerun it. Okay, so I've gone ahead and added just a simple line here that says that when the countdown timer gets to zero, show some celebratory emojis and say that the product is live and then show some confetti or something. I don't know what it's gonna do. Now, I wanna mention that I actually deleted the files that are created, but I'm pretty sure you can just go ahead and edit those without having to rerun the whole thing. And it's probably gonna cost a little bit more money the way that I'm doing it, but why not? We're just experimenting. So let's go ahead and run it again. I'm gonna go back to the terminal, run countdown landing again. It'll probably ask me some clarifying questions once more. Input validation for product name, specify the styling and the emojis to be used. Okay, let's see what it wants me to say. Please provide more details on the desired CSS styling. Make the countdown timer numbers as big as possible. Center of the screen, make it responsive. We want it to stay on same line before page break. Okay, what else does it want? I don't know why it keeps saying no. It's almost like it's angry at me. So, okay, it's making an index file, a main.js, and a style. So that's pretty much everything we expect. It's very simple. So we'll be back when this is done. Okay, it's done now, and it's going to run a Python server again. So let's go ahead and just click yes. And apparently it's already in use because the server was never killed. So it should already be running. Let's go ahead and check that out. Okay, so the thing looks a little bit different. That's fine. We can go ahead and mess around with the CSS and stuff, but let's just see if it works first of all. So on my super app, seconds until launch, let's just say 5 seconds and then start. And it's counting down. Yay, and we got some emojis. Okay, so it worked. That was actually pretty cool. It built, for all intents and purposes, kind of a full app, I guess. It's obviously not deployed, and there's still a lot of styling that needs to be done, but there was a lot of boilerplate code that we didn't need to write. And if we go ahead and check in the workspace here, we can see a lot of the stuff that's generated for us. It's got the instructions, the prompt that gets fed to GPT-4, sort of the clarifications that it asks for, the entry point, and then ultimately all the code that it wrote. And you can see here some utility functions to update the timer and to start the countdown. Great. Okay, so now I'm going to create another app. It's going to be probably even more simple, but it's just going to be a button where you can click and you can upload types of files. I think I'm going to make it probably text and sort of CSV files, and let's see how that goes. All right, so the new project is just going to be called File Upload, and very simple name. And remember, this is just going to be an HTML and a little bit of JavaScript to basically have a button that you can click, and it's going to open your Finder and probably going to restrict it to only certain types of files. So let's just create this make prompt, which is the sort of entry point here. And we'll go and find the project. It is now called file upload. So we should have main prompt, and we're not writing a snake game anymore. And let me pause this and write out this prompt so that we don't waste anybody's time. Okay, so now this application, for this application, I've just said write a JavaScript application that has file upload functionality. It's pretty straightforward. It should be a single page application, although I'm hoping it understands what I mean here. I don't mean that like an SPA, like a React app or something like that. I just mean one file, one index HTML file with a script tag. And the user should be able to select a file to upload. And once it's uploaded, the console will print done. So we're just going to go ahead and check the developer tools and see if it prints done. Let's just put done uploading. Okay, obviously the file isn't going to go anywhere, but it should be able to open up a thing where you can select a file. So let's go ahead and run that. GPT engineer, projects, file upload. Okay, should ask us for some clarifying questions. Summary of areas that need clarification, file types allowed, maximum file size, the design, the storage location. Okay, these are questions that make sense. Clarifying questions, what types of files should be allowed? Only text type files, like PDF, is PDF a text type file? I don't know, PDF, TXT, let's just do like Excel, is that Excel? And CSV, how about that? I wonder if it's actually would do that validation if I like tried to upload a picture, if it would tell me I can't do it. Remaining unclear areas, what's the maximum file size? Let's say 1 gigabyte. We're never gonna upload a text file that big, but you never know. Okay, user design, where is it going to store it? Where should the uploaded files? Do not store the files. I don't wanna do all this right now, set up a backend to store the files, although it could probably store them in the file system. But for now, I just want to print something out. Do not store the files, simply output to the console, file upload complete. And some celebratory emojis. Let's do that again, that was fun. Okay, remaining unclear, what should the user interface look like? The interface is very simple. Again, I'm probably just wasting tokens here and it doesn't need all this, but sometimes it's hard to not talk to the machines like they're people. But anyway, I guess the more explicit you make it, the better. So the interface should be very simple. It is just a large button with a gradient color that says select file. How about that? Okay, and it still has more questions. Are there any additional features or functionalities you'd like to include? Answer in text or C to move on. No, just a button that allows you to select a file from the Finder. Okay, let's go. Build the application. Why does it keep saying no? I don't know what that means. Okay, good. It's not creating a React app, which is good. It's just index HTML with some CSS and JavaScript. And I'm gonna pause it and come back when it's done and we're gonna try to use it. Okay, it looks like it's done and it's telling us it's a single HTML file where you can select a file. It's got some CSS for a button. File size limit, everything looks good. It wants to run a server. Let's go, let's just go ahead and press yes. And it's now running on port 8000. Let's go ahead and check that out in the browser. Okay, so here we are, moment of truth. I'm gonna click select file. Matter of fact, I'm gonna open the console first because remember we'd asked it to print out when it's done. So let's go ahead and select a file. And it opened it up, cool. CSV, open, file upload complete. Nice, look at that. That's awesome, and it even has the emojis. Okay, now let's go ahead and check out what it actually made in the workspace. So all of the stuff that it creates is here in this workspace sort of directory, and you can see the application file, the index.html, which actually calls the script, and it even has a sort of like a bash script that you can just run. Instead of having to run the server, you just do bash run sh. And the styles, and of course it helps to know a little bit of CSS and HTML and JavaScript so that you can edit this, but very simple application. If you had like no dev experience at all, you could probably do this and then maybe even ask ChatGPT to teach you a little bit and you could take it further, learn how to deploy it, etc. So at the end of the day, it's nothing too crazy. It's not a super app that does all kinds of stuff, has authentication, has payments, all of that stuff, but I could imagine that it's possible. And I'm looking forward to seeing some apps where, although I'm sure you could do it in this some way by editing something here in the memory or in one of these clarify files, you could probably eventually give it more input once it's done, or even just edit this prompt and re-hit the GPT for completions endpoint and get a better app back so that you can sort of iteratively edit on it. And that's all very cool. And the last thing I want to say is GPT Engineer has a pretty cool Discord that with a lot of helpful people. And there's a lot of very cool projects in there. I saw one which was a Streamlit upload thing. Here it is, a Streamlit dashboard. And although the creator had to do some editing to get the requirements to install, it actually pretty much did a lot of the work. So anyway, that's it for this video, guys. I'm really excited about the generative code projects. They're all very elementary. We're not, you know, it's not AGI yet. We still need developers and engineers. But I think for people just getting started, it's pretty useful and a very cool learning tool. And I will end this video by saying, you know, learn to code, okay? You don't need to become a software engineer or a scientist and work at NASA to be able to write cool scripts or even build simple apps that you could eventually turn into businesses, et cetera, et cetera. All right, guys, I'll leave it there. Hit me up in the comments if you have any questions. I look forward to seeing y'all in the next video. Peace.